In Haiti, surviving and coming out of a terrible earthquake, holding everyone in this world that is suffering the massive fires that burn around the world. Know that we hold all joys and all sorrows of this past week, including those that live in your heart that are unsaid. I invite you now into a more quiet, reflective time of meditation, reflection, and prayer with Julia and Skylar Lethbridge. I will be released.
Thank you.
an interesting thing happened in creating the service today. I had reached out to musicians and asked them to pick any song they wanted to play. It gets a little tricky when they come back and they're like, how are we gonna put these all together? But that's where amazing things happen, as I looked at words and looked at lyrics and things seemed to come together. And so I kind of have loosely divided the service into just a couple of small things that I will say between the rest of the musical pieces. And it kind of came out to where we have been and where we're going. This present time in which we are living, encompassing the full 18 to 20 months since the start of COVID pandemic, has been a time like no other for all of us. This present time has been about pushing our boundaries, unwrapping unknown fears, facing lengthy periods of isolation and divisions, causing us to look deeply into ourselves, to examine who we really are and what is most important to us, and how to develop new tools and systems to support us. Our challenges have been ever present in the fabric of our politics, our public health, our spiritual lives, and our personal stories. Yet there is also wonder and beauty to be found in how we rose to meet these challenges. And these efforts to meet our challenges created a song all of their own. We have taught ourselves new ways to rethink worship, community, family, fundraising, and the needs of our societies and our cultures in order to cling to what worked, and in doing so, build towards a brighter, more meaningfully connected future. And perhaps what we have learned is that sometimes when the unexpected upends our lives in ways that are beyond our control, perhaps it is the universe telling us that often some of the best moments and lessons in life come to us from, in words our friend Jeff Chamberlain will sing in a moment, nothing more than a universe of possibilities. And this congregation leapt blindly and willingly into that universe of possibility in order to keep this beloved community together. And that in and of itself is worthy of recognition. I believe Jeff speaks to this eloquently in his next song, Something Out of Nothing.
Thank you.
Jeff. Mm-hmm. I love your message. I love your lyric. I love your guitar playing. I just love you. Yeah. You too. This idea of offering yourself a chance to step into a moment in your life, that we each have the power to create our lives and our loves. And this present time of COVID has taught us to love and view the world in very new and different ways. There have been joyful times, like when we had to quickly adjust our first spring fundraiser in May of 2020, but found that we could feel together in love and community and raise money with our Laugh-A-Lot Zoomathon. And where this entire congregation stepped up and gave us funny videos, humorous songs, made the ultimate sacrifices, gave financially for the good of SFUU. And then we had Marcia shaving her head to put us over the top financially. What more commitment can you have than that? We have shared the loss of loved ones during this time from our community at a time when we couldn't hug and share the grief and had to share our mourning apart from one another, yet still connected through Zoom and supporting and caring. The love and strength this community has for one another is one which should be celebrated loudly and celebrated often. While living privately in our homes, isolating for the good of all, as a people of conscience, we may have often felt the burdens of that human distancing, a lack of the healing power of hugs and handshakes, the loss of friendship moments shared over a cup of coffee or a pint of beer. Alone in our homes, we have had to push through differences with family members, tough politics, frightening news stories of attacks on our democracy, racism, greed, and grift. But also alone in our homes, we found new aspects of our lives together, ways to reach out and connect and remain connected. And every Sunday, this SFUU, our little UU community, has kept the light of love on. Every Sunday we gather in Zoom and see our smiling faces, share in the community and of worship, meditation and song, a light in the darkness, a beacon of hope and better days to come. And what this really speaks to for me is that through our words and our music, perhaps we have discovered in a deeper way that our tools of worship and song are a solid foundation of this relationship that we share, both as individuals and as a community. Our songs tell us there is more hope somewhere. There is always more love. And like the love between people, it sometimes creeps up on you quickly before you know what you're about. Other times it grows and spreads like the deep satisfaction that occurs when you fall in love with another. And sometimes those are the most powerful moments in our lives. Those moments when our gratitude for the reality of how good things actually are steps up and slaps us in the face with the knowledge that it is within our power to recognize that gratitude and focus on the light and focus on the good. And we need to embrace these moments. We need to celebrate them with the same joy and exuberance and wonder that occurs when Cupid's arrow strikes your heart. I now invite Hank Flores to share a song about such a moment of recognizing love.
Great. Thank you, Vicki. Thank you. Just in the interest of context a little bit, I'm going to be singing a song from a musical. And it's interesting, just piggybacking off what Vicki said. She asked about singing a song, and I was thinking of all of these, you know, deep, heavy songs to match these deep, heavy times. And yeah, I was thinking about an interesting phenomenon that's not exactly a science to it, but if you look sort of at the trajectory of the general vibe of society, a lot of times the art reflects it. And if you look at like cinema during World War II, you have a huge uptick in very light plot, heavy comedy and heavy, you know, dancing and basically a little reprieve from life. So with that understanding, at the Florence family house, we've been listening to a lot of musicals recently. And one musical that is not super well known is a musical called She Loves Me, which was written by two gentlemen who are much more famous for writing Fiddler on the Roof. But She Loves Me is an adaptation of a wonderful movie called Shop Around the Corner, a Christmas movie with Jimmy Stewart. that I recommend you all watch this Christmas, but it was adapted later on into a movie that most of you are probably much more familiar with Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan, called You've Got Mail. And it basically tells the story of two people who are co-workers who hate each other. They meet and initially are a little attracted, and then one of them says something that ticks the other one off, and one of them has to eventually quit. They hate each other so much. Erstwhile, the same two people have fallen deeply and passionately in love with each other through a lonely hearts club, where they're writing anonymous letters to each other by night. So at day they hate each other and fight, and at night they pour their souls out about literature and art and music. And then they've arranged a first date. He goes to see her and looks through the window and sees who his love truly is, and doesn't know what to do with this information. So he goes in and tries to talk to her, and understandably, it goes horribly wrong. But he's still, in this December night around Christmas time, stumbles back out into the street and is processing all of this new information. So that takes you to this song. Here we go. She Loves Me, from the musical She Loves Me. Well, wonders never cease. I didn't like her. Didn't like her. I couldn't stand her. Couldn't stand her. I wouldn't have her. I never knew her. But now I do. And I could. And I would. And I know. She loves me, and to my amazement, I love it, knowing that she loves me. She loves me, well, true, she doesn't show it. How could she, when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loathed me, bah! Now today she likes me, ha! And tomorrow, my teeth ache from the urge to touch her. I'm speechless, for I mustn't tell her, 'cause it's wrong now, but it won't be long now before my love discovers that she and I are lovers. Imagine how surprised she's bound to be. She loves me. She loves me. I love her. Isn't that a wonder? I wonder why I didn't like her. I like her. That's the thing that matters. And matters are improving daily. Yesterday I loathed her, boo! Now today I love her, woo! And tomorrow, I'm tingling, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling, what the hell does that mean? I'm freezing, that's because it's cold out. But still I'm incandescent, and like some adolescent, I'd like to scrawl on every wall I see. She loves me. She loves me. Thank you.
Generosity is a spiritual practice of this congregation. When we offer our time, our talents, and our treasure, we deepen our engagement and become part of building the beloved community together. As part of our ethic of generosity, we also split our collection plate with a local community organization aligned with our values. This month, the Share the Plate recipient is Sierra Streams Institute. They are a watershed monitoring, research, and restoration group out of Nevada City, California. Our their mission is to link water, science, and people for the benefit of human and environmental health. With our online services, we obviously don't pass the basket, but we ask you to contribute to our collection after the service by going to our website or using text to give. If this is one of your first times visiting with us, please know that you are our guest and there is no expectation that you contribute. Please take a few minutes if you are willing to donate and listen to hymn number 402, From You I Receive. We know we're not at the end, but at least we're moving forward. Today, we say goodbye to our dear Zoom for Sunday services. Zoom will still be with us for our meetings and many other opportunities, but let's try and get back together in person. We look forward to coming back together in person while creating opportunity to watch our services live from home for those who are yet unable or uncomfortable in returning just yet. We are all embarking on a new journey, a hike into the new unknown. It is with familiarity that we return to our church home, but also with an openness to the new and the unfamiliar. We know that some of these next steps forward will be uncomfortable or frustrating, and others will be joyous and uplifting. For we walk now with a new minister, a new vision, a new world that, while still rocked by disharmony and challenge, is also one in which our stories of kindness and love continue to grow brightly. It has been said before that it is not the destination, but the journey. I ask that you think on how you will join SFUU on the next leg of this journey as Patty and I share the next song, The Climb.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming. There's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken.
Ain't about what's waiting on the
the climb.
It is the climb. And keep climbing we must. We know all of life is about the struggle. It's about taking chances. It's about starting again. It's about stepping up and moving over and moving through it all. Remembering that whether we choose to stop, step away, or step in, there is always one more step to be taken. I hope that you have enjoyed this Sunday of music and that in your daily lives, you continue to take the time to celebrate and find the music that brings solace and joy to your life. For the power that I find in music is the same power that threads through each of us in whatever way you walk in your world. Through the ways you volunteer, the way you work in the world, for the support and energy it takes to give your family and your friends kindness or knowledge that you share. Each tidbit you share in the world makes a difference. And when we come together to share with one another, we can only strengthen our power. SFUU may be small, but we be mighty. In the words of the incomparable anthropologist Margaret Mead, never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has. We, this beloved community of SFUU, we are a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens. Our community and the world at large needs us to keep singing the song. I invite you now again, if you are willing at home, to stand up, step away from your computer. You guys come back and let's sing our closing hymn one more step. And please stick around after. We're not going to have recorded announcements. We're going to head into our forum, so please stick around for that.
Okay. Ready, everybody?
You supported SFUU. We cannot thank you enough, and we look so forward to our brand new future.
Woo!